another Magic TV. Joined today is Matt Ness.
Hi, everyone.
How are you doing today?
Good.
Mashi Scanlon and Josh Erlane are not on the show today because they're actually both on their way to GP Liverpool. Channel Fireball is actually hosting that tournament. And for those of you guys who are from Europe, there are only 100 slots left. 100 Jeez. Slots left. It's going to sell out. So make sure you pre-register now because there's a hard cap of 1,850 people. So Wrapter decided to go to Liverpool along with Luis, who's actually going to be at the tournament. And
was he smart enough to pre-reg at least?
Luis, I would say that it's 50-50. I don't know. He's becoming more of an adult recently than before, so things might change. But yeah, they're on their way to Liverpool, and Tom Martel was supposed to join us, but he is currently sick. Yeah. Or stuck in traffic or whatever. But
he's Martelling.
He is Martelling. So, yeah, the GP, of course, GP Liverpool in England this weekend. But there's also another GP this weekend, and I believe you are going to go to that one.
I am,
And what is that one?
Grand Prix Miami.
And the format is?
Standard.
Do you have a sweet deck?
I'm not sure. I'm still working on it a bit.
Okay, okay. I mean, I've been playing a decent amount of Standard, too. I've been like trying to play a different deck every day for the last week, and I think the standard format's really, really good.
Yeah,
it's this is I think the best standard has been in a while.
Yeah,
just so many like viable decks. Like you can play a control deck, you can play a mid range deck, you can play an aggro deck. I mean, and there's just so many different variations of the deck. Every week something is changing, right? I mean, and honestly, like I would probably choose to play Abzan midrange.
Yeah, there were 5 in the top 8 of the last week's Grand Prix.
Of GP Memphis, and I don't know, like how much has changed since then. Can't have been that much, right?
No, I
like,
don't think so.
How are you going to figure out a plan to beat Siege Rhino on turn 4 or whatever, right? It's just too much a lot of the time. So, standard for Miami. Have you been testing a lot?
Yeah, I wouldn't say a lot, but a non-zero amount.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you're chasing pro points right now, aren't you?
Yeah, I'm in a weird spot where I have 16 pro points, I need 20 to get silver to qualify me for Brussels. This may be familiar to...
Ah, so the classic Paul Cheon invite, huh?
So mine isn't quite as ridiculous. I have 2 Grand Prix and I need 4 points instead of 1 needing 6.
But... Yes, I had to actually win the tournament. So you need to pick up 4 pro points and 2 GPs. We have GP Miami, which is coming up this weekend. I think that's constructed, so that's like your bread and butter right there.
Yep.
And then
I would say that's my best chance.
And then there's GP Cleveland, correct?
The week after, yeah. I'm actually staying in Miami the week in between. There's a group of.
What are you guys doing? Just hanging out?
Just hanging out. Yeah, it's awkward because Cleveland is limited, so we can't really test for it that much, and we've already like played a lot of the limited.
You can build some pools together.
We can build a few sealed pools, but mostly we're just hanging out in Miami.
I mean that sounds like a lot of fun. You guys, you guys don't want to go to Cleveland ahead of time?
Yeah, we thought about that, but besides that spring break in Miami.
I feel like there's just a little more upside hanging out in Miami.
Yeah, yeah.
Definitely. So. There was a couple of tournaments that happened last weekend. There was a standard tournament, a big standard open, and a modern open. And it looks like Gerard taking down yet another tournament in modern.
Unbelievable.
And his brew, this is not even a deck. Like, this is not a deck anybody plays.
No.
He just plays this
really
concoction that he made.
He's playing with Thragtusk.
Thragtusk? What is that good against?
I
Burn?
Couldn't tell you.
It's unreal. And he's just... He's been one of the hottest players in the open circuit right now. He's just been crushing tournaments left and right, and I don't know, maybe all he's been playing is Soul Tide Control in every format.
Yeah, no kidding.
I guess maybe that's...
He wins in standard with Rakshasa's Secret and then moves on to...
He wins a GP with... That makes a little more sense, winning a GP with Rakshasa's Secret because it's limited. But then he plays it in standard, and now he's choosing to play Thragtusks in modern. It is absurd. If I'd like get this deck real quick,
It's at the back.
It's at the back, and if you look at Gerard's list here, it's got. It is a doozy. It's got.
It has very few creatures, right?
Well, it's got 3 Snapcaster Mages, 4 Tarmogoyfs, 2 Thragtusks, a Golgari Charm.
A main deck Golgari Charm. That's
2 Ashioks. Ashiok.
What are you gonna steal?
When are you bringing in Ash? Like, what matchup are you trying to play Ashiok
against? It's against Junk, I think.
If you get a Rhino or a Tarmogoyf?
Yeah, that would be pretty good.
All right, so it's good against Shuckle. It doesn't do anything against Splinter Twin.
Yeah, you don't have the Splinter Twins to put on their Deceiver X.
It doesn't do anything against Amulet.
If you
it doesn't
Titan,
do anything against Burn.
But, yeah. Yeah, you steal the Burns Goblin guy. It's
like, I can get behind most of the other cards, actually. Like, you know, Jace is a good value card,
sure.
Kessiger, but, I mean...
You play Jace in the sideboard of your twin deck, right?
Yeah, exactly. And he's playing a more... It seems like a more traditional control deck. He's even playing with two Damnations.
Yeah. Damnation is sweet.
Compulsive Research. He's using Serum Visions as a way
compulsive
to manipulate
Research
his deck.
Compulsive Research is Raptor's favorite card, or one of them.
Compulsive Research is great.
Yeah.
Although, I mean, I only played it back in...
like block constructed or
block. What format was that? Was it Lorwyn?
It was in Ravnica.
Ravnica, yeah. Compulsive Research was like the best common.
Yeah.
And they're not going to print card draw like that anymore, I don't think.
I don't think so.
Yeah. But it was a sweet deck, and you have to hats off to Gerard. He just keeps winning with these decks, and he was able to go through a beat down on some Splinter Twin decks, which
There was a lot of Twin in the top eight. Right?
Yeah, there were three Splinter Twin decks in the top eight, all piloted by known players. You had Todd Anderson. And Seth Manfield got second.
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
You know, I mean, Gerard's deck plays Abrupt Decays and Hand Disruption. It's probably good against Splinter Twin, but I don't know how... It seems like some of the other matchups are... I guess he's just basically playing blue junk, right?
Yeah, just junk with blue instead of white.
Yeah,
so are the blue cards like Snapcaster and Compulsive and Ashiok better than Lingering Souls and Rhino?
Well, I don't know about Ashiok... But Snapcaster made this sweet.
Snapcaster is a good card.
He's also playing Cryptic Command.
Wow.
I don't know how his mana base can support that.
Yeah, I'm also curious how he could beat the Splinter Twin decks with their Blood Moons in the sideboard. You can leave up mana for Decay, I suppose.
Yeah, and he doesn't have access to... He's not playing Pathfinder, but he's playing three Disfigures in the sideboard. I'm trying to figure out all this... This deck is...
Yeah.
I'm trying to figure out how this deck works. And I'm not... It's at least sweet.
It's
right?
At least sweet, yeah.
It's something different, and Gerard was able to pilot this to victory, so...
Creeping Tar Pit is also an unbelievable card I see he has there.
Oh, yeah.
You can steal a lot of games with that card.
Right.
It's deceptively
He's also
powerful.
Got Knight of Souls Betrayal.
That's a strong one against Twin.
And Infect,
yeah.
Yeah,
really good in the current metagame. Yeah. So some of the stuff he's doing does make a lot of sense.
Yeah. So, I mean, it's kind of interesting. It's kind of cool just going through the modern decks here. Three Splinter Twin decks in the top eight. I've always been championing that Splinter Twin, best deck in Modern, in my opinion.
Yeah.
And put three, and all the good players were playing it, so. That's all I got to say about that.
Unfortunate that you didn't top eight with it, but.
Yeah, I got boggled.
Yeah, we both had the same record at Vancouver.
Yeah. Hey, that's a good finish, though.
Yeah, it's not
the
bad.
Finish top 16, that's where you got three more points, so.
Yeah.
You hopefully, best of luck to you. Hopefully you can get four more pro points.
Yeah, fingers crossed. Yeah.
And then I'll join you
in Brussels.
Yeah, join us in Brussels. That would be awesome. So that was Modern. And then there was a Standard tournament as well, of course.
Yeah.
First place being red, white. I guess it's not tokens. It's just straight red, white. Red, white control.
Yeah, it's not quite like Benes's deck, but it's in a similar style.
Yeah, and it's just red white has just been performing left and right. It's just, I think largely in part having access to playing four Chainthrow Rocks. That card just seems ridiculous.
It's not like Swords to Plowshares is a legacy playable card, so
right.
Getting to play with a card similar to that in Standard isn't fair.
Unlike Raptor, who said that Oppressive Rays was kind of like similar of Swords to Plowshares, this is legitimately. Like, as close as you can get in Standard to Swords and Plowshares.
Sorcery speed, vulnerable to enchantment removal.
Right.
Has a few problems, but...
But nobody's playing enchantment removal main deck, right?
Yeah, so it's only, like, the sideboard that
would
be a
Nobody's
problem.
Playing Banishing Light. People have maybe one or two utter ends in their junk decks, but that's it. So, I mean...
The Memphis Abzan decks had a surprising amount of utter ends. I think most of them had two or three, even.
Well, it makes sense if you're expecting these... Hard to deal with enchantments. Chain to the Rocks and another card that's seeing a lot more play thanks to Ben S. Outpost Siege.
Yeah, that is a sweet one.
Yeah, and I think people have just been foregoing playing Chandra's now because Chandra can just die.
Yep.
And just playing Outpost Siege and just using it as a personal Howling Mind.
Yeah, and every once in a while you get to use the Dragon's Mode also.
I have not seen that happen. I played against somebody who I think misclicked. And click dragons, and he had like a just hurling outburst, and that was an 18. Yeah. And I was just like, man, he played Outpost Seed. I can't win. Yeah. And he just clicked Dragons, and I was like, all right, well, can't lose. Yeah. And then he drew two more Hurtling Outbursts. And I was like, wow. Oh, man, if he draws another Outpost Seed Navy Dragon, this might actually put me in trouble.
Yeah.
But, the card actually just seems ridiculous, and Ben was just took it all away. He played four copies.
Yeah, he also had four Soulfire Grandmaster, which this list did not have.
Yeah, I think, I don't know, a lot of these decks in the open chose not to go full Outpost Siege or whatever. Yeah. But, I mean, the list still seems solid. Sam Party piloted this deck for a while in Standard and made top 8 of GP Denver with the deck. He beat me because I don't know how to tap my mana correctly. But, I mean, this deck won the tournament, and I think it's one of the best decks in Standard right now.
Definitely.
It's definitely, of the decks you want to beat, red-white has to be on your radar.
Yeah, red-white and Absinthe have to be the top two.
So, what can you play to actually kind of try to target red white like what kind of deck is actually good against red white
so it's weird because it has a surprising amount of late game for an aggressive deck, but it still is an aggressive deck. So any of the cards that can buy you time, like cheap removals, sweepers are okay. Back to Nature is sweet because it gets chain and Outpost.
It gets you can blow people out with that.
Yeah, if you ever get a chain and bring back a Siege Rhino and kill their Outpost Siege, it's just
really disgusting. Although I have found that the decks that can play Back to Nature usually play Course of Crucifix.
Yeah.
And I had that interaction come up, and I wanted to die.
Disgusting. Yeah.
I was just like, turn 3 Course of Crucifix. All right, I'm looking pretty good. And then he goes Outpost Siege, and I'm looking at my Back to Nature. I'm like, I don't even know what to do there.
Yeah, the perfect fit for the card was in the Abzan aggro decks that didn't play Courser and just had Fleece Mason.
Yeah, but Owen Turtwell posted a list that had Coursers in the updated list.
So even the Abzan aggro decks are playing Courser now. So
it's
tough.
I think it's just, there's a pretty easy solution. You just don't play Courser and play Back to Natures. That's all you got to do, right?
Yeah, don't play the best green card in Standard in your green decks.
Well, I mean, if you're an Abzan aggro deck, maybe it's not as necessary. So I actually ended up beating him by playing the second Courser and just pretending I didn't have Back to Nature, and I just raced him. I was like, Courser, Elspeth.
Yeah.
All right, whatever. Just
mulligan the Back to Nature.
I'm just going to try to beat you down. All right. So beyond that, one sec. I know a lot of you guys are wondering, of course, about Fate Reforged spoilers. We will get to them shortly. That's obviously the thing that everybody wants to talk about. Getting second place by Kevin Jones. This is old school Jeskai aggro. This is Mantis Rider,
Rappel. Not tokens, no ascendancy.
No. It's just, I think this is the deck that maybe Martin Juza played. And the only reason why I think it's the deck Martin Juza played is because it's got 3 Dig Through Times and 1 Treasure Cruise. I don't know how you come to that conclusion.
Oh, yeah.
But there it is. So once again, he was playing 4 Rabble Masters, 4 Mantis Rider, 4 Seekers, 1 Soulfire Grandmaster, 1 Outpost Siege, bunch of Burn Spells and Valorous Dances. And, I don't know what exactly happened to bring Jeskai back, but it's having a lot more success recently.
Yeah, I'm not positive either.
Yeah.
Maybe the blue cards are good against the Abzan mid-rangey, the slower Abzan decks.
Right.
That could be.
I've noticed that the Abzan decks are getting slower and slower.
Yeah. And
they took out the Caryatids,
which
means, you can no longer play turn 3 Siege Rhinos and race them. They replaced them with removal spells, which are decent, but they're also playing like End Hostilities, which are really not very good.
This deck plays one threat at a time most of the time, so End Hostilities isn't going to 2-for-1 it very often.
Right. And Kevin didn't even play with Storm Breaths in his main deck. He just had Sarkhan, so End Hostilities just gets blanked even more. So I think this was just a really excellent metagame choice by him. And
Really smart.
Jeskai aggro, I think Jeskai's a good deck, and I think Raptor would be happy to see this. Although, once again, he's going to be at GP Liverpool opening some sealed decks. So Citadel Siege needs to be in his pool.
Yeah.
I'll tell you that much.
I actually thought that card might see some Standard play, but so far it really hasn't.
It's also Modern play.
Did it?
Team Hareruya, were all on junk, and they had I saw Citadel Siege. And it was the Mirror Breaker.
Okay.
Fighting, you know how we decided to play Gavinny Township?
Sure.
They're just like, all right, well, we're just going to play. First of all, you want a card that can't get Inquisitioned or Abrupt Decayed. So you want 4 drop or higher. They're like Citadel Siege.
Sure.
My Tarmogoyfs are bigger. My Siege Rhinos are bigger. My tokens are bigger.
Yeah. So, doesn't seem unreasonable.
Yeah. Let's see. Let's see if there's any other sweet, interesting decks in the top eight here. There was an Abzan aggro deck that was playing Warden of the First Tree.
Oh, yeah. That deck looked kind of interesting.
Yeah. I mean, it's weird because it looks like it's got four Defiant Strikes in it. What do you think about that?
It's to go with the Prowess guys. It has Seeker and Monastery Mentor.
Which is still very much legal. It is still very legal in Standard right now.
Yeah.
I thought somebody said it might get banned or something.
Well. I didn't say it would get immediately banned.
Oh, we're still waiting. We're still buying time until all the pieces fit together before it gets banned.
Yeah. For those of you who don't know, I said I thought Monastery Mentor was so powerful it might get banned in Standard.
And it's not seeing play anyway. It's actually seeing the most play in Vintage.
Yes.
People are actually
playing. It works really well with Moxes and Black Lotus because it triggers off any non-creature spell.
Right. But not so much in Standard.
Yeah, we'll see.
Whirling Outburst, Goblin Rabble Master, and just Mantis Rider are still king.
Yeah, there are very good 3-drops in Standard right now, which makes it tough. But I still think Mentor might.
You gotta wait for them to rotate out.
Maybe.
Yeah. So, and of course, Blue-Black Control making the top eight, and
this one didn't splash green, correct?
Yeah, this is just straight Blue-Black Control, and. I don't know if you've tested any of them. Is there a certain color combination that you like? Do you prefer the blue-black deck or the blue-black green
deck? I think the green is worth it. Yeah. Sultai Charm is so important because cards like Outpost Siege are so... Like, this blue-black deck has very few answers to Outpost Siege, right?
It's got one Perilous Bolt.
That's not a lot.
Two Ugins.
That barely counts.
Yeah. I'm just telling you the outs.
Sure.
Just telling you the outs.
Yeah, so I would prefer Sultai Charm for that reason.
Yeah. Yeah, I definitely I tested the Sultai deck. I haven't played the blue black deck in a while, but I tested the Sultai deck and I was pretty impressed. Incredibly clunky opening hands.
Oh yeah.
I've had so many opening hands where my hand is just Dig Through Time, Treasure Cruise, Kiora, and four lands.
Yeah, or Ugin or Garak.
And I'm just. And I feel like that's just not an unreasonable opening hand to get with that deck.
Do you mulligan when you get a hand like that?
I don't, if I have a Scryland, it's weird, because, so many hands are mulligans then. So many hands are mulligans, so, it's good because the whole idea behind the deck is it goes over the top of
everything.
All the green decks, right? Yeah. But, it comes at a cost.
Yeah, if you have that hand and they're playing red-white, you just lose on the spot, right?
Yeah, or Jeskai.
Or Jeskai.
I found that the red-white is actually easier to deal with. Because Bioblite kind of kills everything, at least when I'm playing the Sultai deck. But when they play blue, and they have Mantis Rider, counter spells, and Dig Through Time, it's a lot harder to win.
Yeah.
And which is maybe another reason why the Sultai decks are the Jeskai decks are doing well, because I think it matches up well against a deck that won Grand Prix Memphis.
Yeah.
I am so far 0-2, or 0-3 against the Jeskai decks that I played against. So, but if you want to play control, this is still the deck to beat.
Yeah,
you agree
play the green, you think?
I agree play the green, only because Outpost Siege became so popular all of a sudden. If it wasn't for Outpost Siege, I think Blue-Black would have just been fine.
Yeah.
But because Ben Stark basically made this card go from $1 to a $10 card, everybody's jamming four of them into their decks. There's a reason, because it is very good.
Yeah.
The blue-black deck doesn't really have too many ways to gain card advantage. It's got the four Dig Through Times and a couple Ingenuities, but everything else, you're just one for wanting them. And if they if an opponent just resolves an Outpost Siege and you just don't have an answer for it, you just die.
Yeah.
I was playing the blue-black green deck, and he played Outpost Siege. I didn't draw Sultai Charm, and I lost three turns later because he just drew more cards than I did. It's just pretty absurd how good that card is.
No, one-sided Howling Mind is not fair.
One-sided Howling Mind in a deck full of cheap, very powerful spells.
Yeah,
that's the thing. All of their creatures and all their spells are really, really good too.
So
that is our Standard breakdown. I think we are going to be doing a power rankings for Standard for this week. We did Modern last week because of GP Vancouver. Woo.